Mr. Francis, in Ihren Songs geht es viel um Liebe. Eben haben Sie auch über Liebe gesprochen, vielleicht auch so, wie sie nicht sein sollte. Was bedeutet Liebe für Sie persönlich?
Love, for me, love is loving the creator, loving my fellow man, you know, loving, you know, my people, you know. When I walked out, I've had so many experiences, you know, that I have to believe in love, and I have to love and love, because the experiences I've had, I've been to places, you know, where I was desolate, you know, I didn't know where I was, didn't know where I was going, and people stopped and helped me, you know, and to me, that was them showing me love, you know what I'm saying? I'm not talking about just love, because, you know, for a woman, you know, I'm talking about we have to love each other, you know, and that is, for me, that is creation, because if Jah didn't love us, he wouldn't have made us, man, and he wouldn't keep us. You know what I'm saying? So for me, love is not just, you know, taking a woman and taking her to bed, you know. I love people, man, you know. And for me, you know, I've been places that, I'll tell you a quick experience. I was working in Girona, in Spain. And Ozzy, you know, from Mosquito Records, Grover Records, he should have come take us to the airport at 5:30 because my flight was 7 o'clock, and he came like, you know, 5:30, 6 o'clock. By the time we got to the airport, you know, the flight was closed, and I ran into to the airport looking around, you know, to see if my flight was still there. And this guy, I saw this guy running towards me. He had on a red jacket, you know, and he says, "Mr. Francis, you know, good morning. Wonderful show you did last night." I said, "Thank you very much," but I wasn't really in. I didn't have time to really listen to what he was saying because I was looking for my flight to see if I missed my flight, you know. And he said, "Don't worry, you know, you'll be all right." And he says, "Just give me a passport." He said, "The flight is closed, but give me a passport." And I said, "Why?" And he says, "If you want to get on the flight." He says, "You can't take the bag on board with you. I'll have to send it through." And when I looked at his jacket, he had an insignia of the operator, you know. And he took my passport, came back and gave me a VIP pass, man. I could go straight to the top. You know, and I felt so humble, man. I mean, it's great for someone to give you this opportunity to make you, you know, you get your flight and you're on board, you know, it's great. But I felt so humble to know that, you know, this guy was so kind, you know, to see me, because when I ran, it was like a scared rabbit, man. You know, if I miss my flight, I'm in trouble, you know. And this guy was so kind, you know, to help me, to give me, you know, a chance to board my flight. And as soon as I sat into the chair and made myself comfortable, a couple walked in. You know the couple we saw today?
Yes.
You know, and she was from Scotland, man. She and her boyfriend, and she came and she said, "Oh, Mr. Francis, can we sit beside you?" I said, "Sure." You know, and I was wondering, who is this? And she said, "Oh, I'm Fee." And the minute she said Fee, I remember, you know, people telling me about her, you know, in Germany, and she follows us all over the place. And for me, you know, I felt so humble, you know, to know that here is someone I don't know, they know me, but, you know, they recognize me and they're making me comfortable, you know. So to me, that is love, you know, true love.
Sie wurden heute von den Goldmaster Allstars begleitet, die ja auch schon am Freitagabend mit Dennis Al Capone gespielt haben und auch am Samstag selbst aufgetreten sind. Was macht diese Band aus?
The first time I played with Malcolm and the Goldmasters, you know, I was really apprehensive about playing, you know, with a band from Southend, you know, a bunch of white guys, you know, Essex, yeah, you know, C-Sex, you know, playing with a bunch of guys, you know, I was very nervous. But when I walked in the studio, man, you know, before they even started, I felt so comfortable with them, you know, and they were saying, "Yeah, bro, you know, want to drink, want to smoke, you know, relax." And when the band started playing, man, he'll tell you, we didn't have a full rehearsal.
No.
You know, because all the songs I was doing, and they started it, I said, "Okay, stop," you know, and they, well, I said, "You don't need to play no more, you know, that's good enough, you know, next song," and they played, I said, "Stop, next one." We didn't have a full rehearsal. I came back and I was saying to everybody, "You guys better watch it. They've got a band in Southend that will kick your ass, you know, the Goldmasters, you know, and... You know, you heard them tonight, you know, bad band. Even the little singer, man, Charlie's bad.
Oh, yeah. Gibt es schon einen Termin für eine neue Tour oder sogar vielleicht eine Veröffentlichung, ein Album, ein neues oder sonstige Tonträger?
Well, I haven't got any dates right now because I've got quite a few dates on the other side of the Atlantic. On the 4th of May, I was inducted in the Reggae Hall of Fame in New York, and I have to collect an award from the Apollo Theater in New York on the 4th of May. And I've got, you know, several shows lined up, you know, across America. So that I do know about. And I've got to come back and do a couple more gigs in England. And then I've got an album that I just finished with Rude Rich and the High Notes in Holland. You know, that's a big, for me, that's a big deal. So I know I've got a few gigs lined up in Holland and also some in Spain. But I'm willing to come back to Germany anytime you'll have me, man, because I love working in Germany, and I have to buy some car parts in Germany. So I'd love to come back, man.
Gab es bei den Konzerten in Deutschland Höhepunkte oder Highlights oder irgendein anderes besonderes Erlebnis?
In this was in Stuttgart, man, a beautiful hotel, and I went to sleep. And just as I lay in bed, you know, before I fell asleep, no, this is no bullshit. This is straight up, right?
Yeah, I do remember.
I lay back in bed, you know, like that, and just for a minute, and I heard, and I thought, fucking hell, guys next door must be really, you know, sleeping heavy. So I got up, and I put my ear, you know, to the wall. And it stopped. The snoring stopped, you know? I was thinking, so I turn around and I switch on the TV and sat on the side of the bed, you know, just for a second, you know. And then I thought, this is bullshit. Might as well go back to sleep. And I turn off the TV, turn off the lights, and then lay back down again. But I turned over this time, this way. And as soon as I turned over, I felt somebody go. And I jumped out of the bed, man. And I said, what the fuck? What are you doing? I was petrified, man, because it's not a tap, it's a push, you know, like some, you know, you lay on somebody and they say, get off, you know, and I jumped out, man. I said, what? And I started cussing and swearing, man. And I said, hey, I said, this is my bed. You know, I said, what are you pushing me out of my bed for, man? I said, you crazy? I said, look, if you want to stay in my, if you want to share this bed with me, it's okay. I don't mind, but don't push me out, man. I paid for this, you know. I said, tell you what, let's put a pillar between us, right? That's your side and this is my side. And I put the pillar there. And I said, let's go to sleep now, all right? And I switch off the lights, put my head back, and in a few minutes I was gone, man.
Really?
That was it, yep.
If you're allowed.
Yep. Yep. And this, I swear, man. This true story.
Yeah, it's a correct story. You
know? Yeah, man. First time, and I never believe in ghosts and spirits and all that shit, but Stuttgart made me believe it, man. And the next day,
the guys from Stuttgart.
I'm telling you, man. The next day, we drove from Stuttgart to Leipzig.
Yeah.
And you know, that's a long drive.
Yeah, it is.
Long drive, man. And all the way driving up, I was saying, shit, man, I got a ghost with me, man. Everything is cool, man. Yeah. I have no problem, man.
We're coming off the show.
Yeah, man. Yeah.